Make us your best. It's your mash. It's your run. Master Distiller's at stake. You got 4 hours. Your time starts now. Good luck, men.
Good luck, my friend.
Yep, good luck.
For the final round, Distillers must deliver their signature shine at a minimum of 120 proof. The one with the best flavor when tempered down to a sellable 100 proof wins.
We got Steve, he mashed in apples. Darrell, he just mashed in corn. Which one you think's gonna come out there, Ma? Which one's gonna have the highest proof?
I'd say the corn will. It'd take longer on that fruit than it will that corn. I'll guarantee you that.
It's a little more unstable, ain't it?
Well, that's why you charge more
for it. Takes longer to work it.
Yeah. We'll know for sure in 4 hours.
How you doing over there, Darrell?
Getting her going.
I got more sediment in my mash than I'd like, but we're gonna get a roll out of there.
Big Steve's got pretty mash.
Going into the run, as soon as I saw my mash and I tasted it, I thought it was where I needed it to be.
He's got all the solids out of it. That's nice looking mash. Good color for apple.
The strainers work really good.
Straight apples. Darrell's charging the hell out of his thump keg with mash.
There's been a whole lot in there, ain't it?
Going into the next run, still's going to stay exactly the same. I'm going to do what I can do with my mash.
Darrell, what'd you drop in there?
Copper to bounce around in there.
All right.
See if I can kick it up a little bit.
The only thing about it is they'll scrub that water out of that alcohol. It'll pull it out and push that proof up a little bit.
Big Steve's a capping up.
He didn't add nothing to it or take nothing out.
I believe he's good. He ain't going to pack his thumb arm.
We have fire.
Big Steve's lit up, boys.
Darrell done started sweating over there. He's getting ready.
Trying to wear it off.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Love apples. Good girl.
Well, the highest proof I ever made was 176.
176?
Let me explain this way I do this. I'll say be 1 gallon of high-proof liquor out of everything I run. My liquor say 140, 50 proof or something.
Yeah.
But I'll proof it down. I'll got a jug of high-proof liquor over here. If I get it too low, I'll bring it back and pick it back
up. Put some high shots in it.
But I make every bit of my liquor taste the same,
yeah,
straight across the board.
That's what you're supposed to do. Well, that's a good moonshiner, and that'd be a good master distiller that's able to do that.
Man, y'all got 1 hour left.
And people don't get it. I mean, if some hobbyist might bring you a pint of 180-proof liquor, but as far as anybody that's ever sold any liquor, you can't get the price that high-proof liquor demands.
It ain't a good idea to drink.
No.
Any liquor, especially above 120 anyway.
Yeah, 120 is about right.
Yeah, man. Don't go above that, because you're going to mess your insides up.
It damn near killed me. It wasn't the liquor about killed me. It just good judgment went out the door.
That stuff's anesthesia and anesthetic. You can rub it on and ingest it, too. Next thing you know, you won't know what happened.
Kutcher's going, Darrell?
Yes, sir.
From the very beginning, it didn't have the head on it that I was expecting. It didn't have the notes I was looking for with the apples. Gee, many crummy. But to get high proof and have a flavor, and a desirable flavor at that, it's damn close to impossible. It's a hard thing to hit right on the head.
That's hot.
Whew. Damn.
How you doing, boy?
I'm dealing with it.
Looks like it's running about right, though. I'll tell you. I'd slow him down just a little bit. A
little more?
That's running a little fast.
He got running hotter than I'd ever run it, but
this high-proof liquor's hard to fix.
Yes, it is. It's an art.
How you doing, old buddy?
Good.
I'd slow that down, too, just a little bit.
All right.
All you need is a quart.
Just one sweet jar.
One?
That's
one
all
quart.
It takes.
They're watching it pretty close, ain't they, Tim?
Yeah, concentration. That's what we're looking for here.
Hey, Darrell. I said it would come out how you wanted it.
I'm catching it gets more flavor.
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping for, too.
Steve's got 6 jars, and Darrell's got 3.
Nice clear jar.
You got the winner, Steve?
I don't know, Darrell.
5 minutes, gentlemen.
My proof's pretty high. Well, it's clean. I think I hit the flavor area that I want. Once it's cut down with water, you know, that changes things a bit.
Just trying to dial in, figure out which one I'm turning in.
All right, here we go. Big Steve.
Bringing it in here, Big Steve.
Old big boy.
Gentlemen.
Good luck.
Good luck.
Here comes old Darrell. He's got his shined up.
Am I nervous? Yeah. But when the day is through, hopefully we're both still friends. But we're going to put out some good liquor. I know that much.
That is pretty.
Yeah,
I ain't kidding.
Hope you guys like swamp juice.
Good luck, Darrell.
I know I left it all out on the floor in there. I didn't have anything else to give.
Win or lose, it's been a great run.
We're looking at Darrell. Darrell made his out of corn.
Let me tell you something, Tim. Right there's the prettiest jar of liquor I've ever seen.
Jose's a jar full of headaches in that right there.
That's damn skull buster
from the word go. That'd make your toenails fall off.
But all we can do is poof her down and try her.
It's high. I don't know if it's as high as yours. I've been sneaking right below you the whole time, so we'll see how this goes.
I dropped a little on this wood, and it's a smoking.
I'll say a 140.
158.
That's pretty damn high.
Pretty good right there.
Hopefully the flavor's there. I know there was some heat.
Come on, look.
It's a little hot on the back end, but it started out at 158. He can make a right smart of it. It tastes like that.
But he's got 5 gallons. He's going to have 7.5 time he gets done tampering.
Yeah.
I can sell that. You can sell that, Mark?
It's good high-proof liquor, ain't kidding. But it's a little hot.
But it's still good liquor.
I like hot-proof liquor.
Now, this is Big Steve's.
I feel like I hit maybe 125.
Big Steve marked her out at 140 proof even.
I think I found my flavor spectrum that I was looking for, but to be honest, I'm just not sure.
And I like that apple right off the nose. When you pick it up, you know it's apple brand.
It ain't as hot as Darrell's.
Nope.
No, it was lower proof.
It's kind of a bland taste, ain't it?
Yeah, I'm kind of disappointed. That apple, I really thought would shine through a little more.
Clean?
Yep.
Clear?
It's a good drink.
I would be certain that Steve came in with lower alcohol in his mash simply because them apples didn't have the time they needed. Yeah. All right, boys. Now, Darrell, you know, we smell that, and that's corn liquor. Really good, good strong flavor, good clear liquor.
And you had one of the cleanest looking jars on the table.
I mean, it
was perfect, clear. If it was full, we couldn't tell anything was in it.
Coming from you, that's a great accomplishment.
You prove you hit it 158.
Thank you.
As hard a liquor as you are making, when you bring her back down to where you can drink it, I don't think you beat the corn liquor. There you go, bud.
Thank you.
Steve, you had a fine apple brandy going on here. We hit that nose, and boy, it was just what you look for, an apple brandy. We told you we were looking for high proof. It's right at 140 even.
140?
So, yep.
So you did good as running the still. You did an outstanding job, good clear, no filter, nothing.
Thank you.
It was just a little bit flat for me. When you do a fruit-based mash, you need a lot more time for fermentation. I think that if you had had another week even, I think your mash would have been 10 times better. You'd have brought a higher proof. But all in all, it was a great flavor.
Both of you did a damn fine job. But unfortunately, they can only be one master distiller out of each bunch. Darrell, you're the next master distiller, buddy. Congratulations.
I feel like I'm floating on a cloud, like it's a dream.
It don't make a damn which one of you got the master distiller, the title. You're both leaving here winners.
The information that I've picked up here, the friendships that I've made, I'm sure not leaving here a loser.
No failures are my buddy. You've done what you're supposed to do.
Thank you. My nickname's Uncle Dum Dum, winning master distiller. I'm no dummy.